We first met Jordan in August 2021, filing this report from Afghanistan. Kabul had just fallen to the Taliban.
All of my beloved Afghan friends have either fled the country or are desperate to flee the country. You know, this is a terror organization.
It was the most terrifying and horrifying thing I've ever been through in my entire life. It just became a ghost town overnight. I mean, hundreds of thousands were trying to get out of the country. We've all seen those images. The people who have stayed, they're out of work, they're poor, they're starving.
At that time, Jordan was undergoing a complicated transition too, gender reassignment, an act which, under the Taliban's strict interpretation of Sharia law, is punishable by death.
It's fascinating because in many ways it was easier to transition in Afghanistan than in Australia, for example.
Why?
Because I was just anonymous. Nobody understood what the changes were, what was going on. I was just completely anonymous and able to do it without any questioning from society.
For all of that, though, was there a fear of what might happen if the Taliban, for example, found out and understood?
Yeah, absolutely. My colleague Teddy and I, we were embedded with a Taliban unit making a film for the New York Times. And we spent 9 months going to this village and staying with them for weeks at a time. And I had breasts at the time. They didn't know that, obviously. To them, I was just a man, which is also a really fascinating thing. Like, I was pre-surgery and they didn't ask any questions. They just accepted me as a man, which was also like an insane thing because I was able to escape these labels that I've been fleeing my whole life in this Taliban unit in the middle of nowhere in Afghanistan. Like, that's crazy.
Home on the farm in the New South Wales Riverina, older sister Brianna remembers Jordan as a headstrong kid.
And the more anyone would say, don't do it, that's dangerous, that's crazy, the more he would go and do it. So you just try not to think about it and hope for the best, really.
I'm a scrubby kid from a dairy farm in Narandra. I got called Dyke. I got called, like, Lezo, all these awful names.
When Jordan started primary school, went to kindergarten, the first day, Jordan wore the uniform, which is a dress, and Jordan said, I'm not wearing that. What do you mean you're not wearing that? You have to wear that. That's a uniform. No, I don't like it. I only wear shorts like the boys. Jordan ended up wearing the boys' grey shorts and the blue shirt. We have a photo of Jordan as school captain, both the boy and the girl, wearing the same uniform.
So, of course, Jordan has to transition in Afghanistan. Couldn't do it in Australia or at home where I could take care of him because I love him so much.
I had these labels on my forehead, right? And when I went to Afghanistan, I was anonymous. They have no idea about what LGBTQIA plus is there, no understanding of it. And I got to rebuild myself or reimagine myself in that anonymity.
You can't go to the local doctor in Kabul and say, can we have this conversation? How do you do it in that setting?
When I came to Australia, I was introduced to a doctor and he prescribed me some hormones. I took them to Afghanistan with me, and then a friend of mine who is a doctor in Afghanistan, he was the one who was injecting me every 3 months. So my voice dropped even more, my face shape changed even more, I got more of a beard. And so all of the people in my neighbourhood in Kabul, they would have seen a drastic change in that 6 months. Nobody said a thing. It was wonderful. Afghans are actually very, very tolerant of difference, as long as you're a foreigner.
Jordan's film, Transition, received glowing reviews at its world premiere at Tribeca Festival in New York.
So, should I go through the men's or the women's security check?
Woman.
I'm so sick of being stressed about this. I just want to have the goddamn surgery.
There is a scene in the film where you're about to go through airport security and you seem genuinely scared.
Yeah. I was wearing a binder, which flattens your chest. And so one day, just suddenly, I was being body searched at the airport by this man, and he patted me down and didn't feel anything, didn't react to anything. So then I realised that as long as I'm wearing the binder, I should be okay.
I'm gay. I spent a lot of time living there, and it wasn't particularly a problem, but it was also, I suppose, not something that I really spoke about. Mm. So I always had the sense that as long as I don't make a big thing about this, it'll be okay.
Yeah, I think you're right. As long as it's not something that is disgust, it's fine. I mean, I had a positive experience transitioning under the Taliban because they didn't know I was trans. If they knew I was trans, it would have been a very different experience. The reason that I was motivated to make the film is because we need to be able to extend our values to people that we don't like. I was having a conversation with one of the Talibs in the village, and one of the villagers asked him, how can that be a man? He doesn't have a beard, talking about me. And the Talib said, manhood is not just about having a beard, manhood comes from within. And I was just like, oh my God, look at this Talib, hello. And then a few minutes later in the same conversation, he said, if I heard a woman's voice coming from another room when there were male guests around, I'd cut her throat. So these kinds of dichotomies exist in all of us, and we need to find a way to have dialogue and get everybody to just compromise and meet in the middle somehow.
The first time I saw the film, I cried. And it was in sympathy, it was in crying in... Can you cry in proudness? The fact that Jordan is such an individual and achieving so much, I think I must have done something right.
You know, the tragic irony is that this country, Afghanistan, it's erasing women, it's erasing their identity, but it gave me my identity. My friend made me this T-shirt, it's really funny. It says, I transitioned and all I got was white male privilege.
An amazing story.
Incredible. Mm. And not to ignore like the nuance and the context and that he has clarified that the privilege was allocated to him because he's a foreigner, but I think what came through for me is there's something so interesting that he felt more comfortable in an environment like that where those kind of dichotomies exist and doesn't feel comfortable here where the weight of labels, is thrust upon him. And that says something about how we treat people who are gender non-conforming and transgender, you know? But it looks eye-opening and incredible.
It was so wonderful to see that it was a positive experience for Jordan.
Yeah, I mean, I'm
just such saying, an intense
I was here at work when Jordan was doing that reporting for us. Yeah. I had no idea at all. I think most of us here had no idea what was going on when Jordan was filing those reports. So it was a real privilege to sit down and meet in person.